any form of rape is disgusting. It hurts at a place where so many people do not even have language to express.
Sio jambo rahisi hata kidogo kwa mtoto wa kiume kuzungumzia kuwa nikiwa na umri fulani mwanaume alinishawishi na kuniingilia. Ni vigumu hata kutazama kwenye kioo na kujiambia hilo mwenyewe.
My name is Onyango Otieno and I am a rape survivor.
Mimi ni Novatus Marandu. Mimi ni mhanga wa unyanyasaji wa watoto kingono nikiwa mtoto.
I wasn't angry when the abuse happened. I was confused. It had been my first sexual engagement and it came in such a harrowing experience. I ended up getting a sexually transmitted infection. It dawned on me 10 years later after my rape ordeal that I had actually been violated because I had been going through therapy. And it's during the therapy process that I actually realized that something had happened to me back there.
Sikusema punde pale unyanyasaji ulipofanyika kwa mara ya kwanza, ya pili, ya tatu na hata mara ya nne. Kwenye jamii yetu hakuna uelewa hasa kwa watoto kuhusiana na kile mtu mzima anachoweza kufanya dhidi yake.
It is not common, first reason, and secondly it's embarrassing, and third reason is humiliating. There is a belief that men cannot be raped, particularly among African men, because biologically, men, they are the one who initiate sex, they are the one who's supposed to be having the penis and become erect, not the woman, and they have the power to stop it if it happens. And the other biggest reason is that because generally sex starts in the head, so if a man is under stress, he is able to be erect.
There are so many people who actually ridicule me coming out with my story. Most of them happen to be men because they don't think, a boy can be raped, a man can be raped. Most of them think I actually enjoyed the experience. I had people I trusted who I could talk to and I was lucky, but I also realized that for many men out there, that was not the reality. And that was one of the reasons why I started voicing out my stories.
Kwa sasa hivi sihisi kukata tamaa. Ulifika wakati nikasema sasa basi. Pamoja na hilo ni kujaribu kuzungumza na jamii ya watu wahanga waliopitia unyanyasaji wa kingono na ulawiti.
I'm happy, I'm strong, I am healthy, I am productive, and the fact that I have done a lot of the inner work is one of the reasons why I'm even able to do this advocacy now, because I'm not particularly very affected by even the stories I hear every day.
We need to change our perceptions around male rape. When sexual violence is performed against a man, it's still a crime.
Society might not be ready for our stories right now, but it is our stories that will make societies ready.